Okay, Natalia, beautiful picture. Please begin.
Thank you. Oh, the stress for me, number one, is the major problem is I don't speak the language of this country. The second is looking for a job. The third is sometimes is low spirit. It's about me. Oh, the other problem, the stress,
is low spirits.
Always is the money. Okay. Yeah, mm-hmm. Is yeah. Necessary.
Oh yeah.
All the time. They buy different thing. The other problem is the family, or the other stress is the major for me is bad hair. This year, no, this year for me. Mm-hmm. Oh, the stress is pandemic. I feel sometimes panic, depression, or if I am guiding my daughter well.
Guiding.
Oh, guiding. Sorry.
No problem.
If I am guiding my daughter well.
Very good.
I thank you.
Bravo, Natalia.
Oh, wait, thank and then you. Family. Don't forget this last one, family. Family.
That's it, teacher.
All right, nice job. Now, I really love the colors that you put on here. Did you paint this? Did you paint it?
Yeah, the pizza is the pepperoni.
No, it looks really delicious.
Yeah.
It looks good.
Good look.
It looks fantastic.
Teacher, mm-hmm. But I don't eat more pizza. Now I have trouble in my health.
Well, maybe you can just draw the pizza instead. We want you to stay healthy. That's very important.
Yeah,
absolutely. So thank you so much, Natalia, for going first. Now, one thing I'd like to do right now is you'll see a little bar on the screen. But I'm going to pull up the video panel so I can see everyone's face. Right now, this is what I mean by finding common ground, is that in class, and particularly with when the class is online, sometimes it's a little harder to make friends. And that's what I think this exercise is very good for, is that we're all in class, we have different stories, different backgrounds, we're different people. But when you talk about the things that give you stress, very often you'll realize that you have something in common with somebody else who may be very different from you. So what I'd like to do right now is ask everybody, would you please raise your hand, or just if your camera's off, just hit the emoji button. Raise your hand if speaking English gives you stress. All right, take a look at the hands up, Natalia.
Yeah.
I love it. Okay, raise your hand if finding the job they want gives you stress.
Mm.
All right. Now this one, guiding my daughter. Raise your hand if your kids give you stress. Now, this is definitely going to be a lot of people. Raise your hand if this pandemic gives you stress. And let's keep going. Money, raise your hand. Feeling sad, raise your hand. Worrying about health, staying healthy. And then family stress. Natalia, guess what? You have so much in common with everybody here. How do you feel now?
A big stress, teacher. A big stress.
Well, guess what? Guess what? Everybody else can share it with you. Okay.
Nice.
Very good. Very good. Okay, so let's go back and who would like to volunteer to share next? So thank you very much, Natalia. All right. Any volunteers? I'm not gonna. If you don't feel like it, I'm not gonna force you. So we have Nerexi, would you like to go?
Yes, I can.
All right, so here we go. And you use Google Drawings. This is a nice tool. All right.
Yes, it's simple. I was worried for the work, Natalia. Natalia work because look beautiful. My pizza is simple, you know.
No, this looks fine. This is great. Yeah. This is a good skill. You could show your classmates how to use. I've never done a lesson showing people how to use Google Drawings. You could teach the class this someday. This is good stuff.
Thank you. Okay, this is my pizza stress pizza. These are more important in my life. Mm-hmm. So my family are another country, including my husband, because he work in another continent. So mm-hmm. he come twice uptime and the year.
Yes.
I have right now two jobs. One is like a nanny, like a babysitter. I have to care a twins, two little baby, beautiful and cute, but mm-hmm. it's a lot of work. Another job is like a server. Just a weekend and Friday and Saturday. So I am very busy the week.
Yeah.
Of course, my school is my English class. I always study and work, so it's not new for me. But right now, this slide is very stress for me. Because I like to do, but it's not my priority. I'm sorry. I try to be honest, you know. So the next slide is a friend. sorry. Thank you. that's right. The next slide is a friend. I try to have. I have to try a space on the week or each 2 weeks for different, because it's healthy for me, my mind, my emotional mm-hmm. health, you know. So I try take a time for friends sometime. It's no stress for me. It's very fun. The next It's like gym time and yoga time is my passion because I am very energy, so I need to do something that I can move. So gym time, yoga time is my favorite slide. So no stress for me. Yeah. The next style is leisure. I love this new word for me. New word for me.
Leisure.
It's a space where I can to do anything or whatever to do. So it's that moment I like to read, to write, to see watch a movie, something like that. It's not the last slide, because it's a circle, so it's no has a third or the last. I don't know if you understand. Pareja is in Spanish. Sorry, I have to translate.
Why are you apologizing?
Yes, it's my relationship with my husband. I have a time, a special time with my husband. However, he work another country. We have a time almost every day for to share how was the day, how is the work, the family. So that is my all pizza express.
Very nice. Really well done. Really well done.
Thank you.
And I know I gave you stress by giving you this assignment, but I think you did a great job.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you for helping me, and thank you for will help me in the future.
Oh, my pleasure. My pleasure. I'm curious, does anyone else have to make time to communicate with family overseas in another country?
Yes, we have a chat. We talk every day, anytime. Sometimes we do FaceTime.
Oh, I mean, not just Nurexia. I'm asking anybody else.
Oh, sorry.
No, it's okay. A lot of other people probably have the same experience.
Me,
taking time. Yeah.
Me, my daughter lives in Brazil, and I have and my family, father, mother, I have to take time. Yes. To talk to them every day.
Mm. Yes. Very nice. Now, I'm sorry I kept Tavares. I'm sorry I kept muting you. I think your headphones. I think the microphone was right next to your nose or mouth, so we were hearing the breath. That's why I muted you.
No problem.
Oh yeah. Oh, Tavares, real quick. I think there was an issue with your attaching your assignment.
No. I'm sorry, teacher. I do, but I forget to send. But
you don't send it. You attach it.
Yeah. Okay.
Attach it. We can go over this later. As later, but you don't want to send it like an email. You want to attach it.
Okay.
The slide. All right. Do we have a volunteer for the next one? Glaucian Perla.
Yes. Yes.
All right. Perla. Here we go. Okay. All right. Here we are. Okay. I'll blow this up. Here we are. There we go. Okay. Perla, tell us everything.
This is my stress pizza. Mm-hmm. The first one is my baby boy help. The past few months, he's doing no well. Mm-hmm. I've been in the hospital every 15 days.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a lot of stress for me.
Mm-hmm.
After money, looking for work is hard when you have a little kids.
Mm-hmm.
The other one, wake up the kids early. I don't know why that is so hard, because they never want wake up. The traffic, I don't have a car, I use public transportation. It's so hard when you want to be on time in some place and you came because something happening.
Yeah.
Cleaning the house, kids homework is the other one hard, because I have a daughter in second grade. She have a lot of homework and is in English. In some time, I can help you her, but the other time I don't understand. And I don't know how to explain to her. Sleep, I don't sleep too much for the same for my baby healthy.
Hmm.
Good every day. I need to think about what I cook for breakfast, for lunch, for dinner. Physical and mental health. After the pandemic started, everything is going crazy.
Yes.
School. I love school. I like to do my homework. But I feel too much stress when I can attend a class because something happens with my baby. I miss the class. That's making a lot of stress for me. And the last one is the relationship.
Mm-hmm.
That's my piece of stress.
Very nice. This is good. This is good. I'm thinking in a minute when we go into breakout rooms, Nurexi, I'm asking your professional opinion. Nurexi, do you have any tips for your classmates who might need to get some extra sleep? Myself included. I would like to get more sleep as well.
Oh, what is the question, sorry?
Oh, I'm asking your professional opinion, because I know you study you're training to be a yoga instructor.
Yeah. For to sleep?
For getting a little bit of extra sleep, just a little more each week, because I think that could help everybody. Do you have any tips?
Yes, I have a practice. It's a short and effective. For to count in your mind when you breathe, inhale and exhale. The name is breathe 7-4. Yes, you can practice it for 5 minutes. You think in your breath and you feel relaxed and you can sleep, or keep calm. The Yeah.
It's okay. Yeah. No, I'm just thinking, so Perla, just I think maybe after class, just send Nurexia a message. This is the kind of thing she does. She's the expert on this sort of thing. So she might be able to give you a few tips.
Okay. Sure. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Fantastic. Let's get, thank you so much, Perla. Let's get, what am I thinking of? Let's get one more volunteer before we go into breakout rooms. Anybody? Glaucian, Cleomaine, Gerson? Does anybody want to?
No, teacher. I want to go.
Alessi, okay. You're not walking. Wait. Tell me you're not like walking down the street, gonna get hit by a car, are you?
Sorry, I'm leaving.
But don't. I don't. I want to make sure you're not like in a dangerous situation, like you're gonna walk into traffic. Okay. You're standing still. All right. Here we go. Let's go to Alessi. Here we go.
Yes. Can you hear me?
We can hear you crystal clear.
Okay.
All right. So let me bring up Alessi's. Da, 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 da. Alessi. Where is she? Come on, Alessi. There you are. All right. We see it.
Okay. Let me Let's see, what is, okay, so I'm going to start with the, I think it's the most stressful for me right now. Mm-hmm. it's the job.
Yes. The job you're working or the job you're looking for?
Hello?
Yeah.
Sorry.
I mean, it's okay. We hear you. Okay. The job you have now or the job you're looking for?
The one that I'm looking for.
Okay.
I mean, the job that I want right now. Mm-hmm. The job that I'm right now. It's stressful. It takes a lot of good energy for me. It's just, it makes me feel like, exhausted, physical, mentally, and then is the housing right now, because since I live by myself and I share a space with the people that are not my family or friends, and I feel like every time you need to find a new places because any reasons, and of course I put like life in the USA, but of course always the job in our housing because of living here. And physical and mental health, because of my life here, my type of job, I got a physical stress, and that affected me my mental health. So it's a big part of the pizza, and of course the world's health. It's just again taking a lot of energy from us, making us feel more tired, and of course more stressed. That's my
pizza. Right. Thank you, Leslie. Now, I know a little bit more about you. When you say physical health, your job gives you a lot of stress. I know that you're working, you still work at the same cafe, right?
Yes. Yes.
So you're on your feet for long, long hours. Am I right?
Yes.
Okay. So I think probably a lot of people here will have that same experience as well. Nurexia knows a lot about that. And Garcon is in the middle of class right now. If Garcon turns his camera on, he can show you exactly what he's doing. He's he's working at this moment on his feet. Yep, there he is. So Gerson can wave at Alessi right now. So he's in class and he's working at this moment.
Yeah, I feel the same thing. I work double every day.
Wait, every single day you work two shifts?
Gerson? I work the shift like 5 days a week.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Gerson, are you like a superhero or something? What are you doing? How do you do it?
I had to bring everything at home, you know?
Yeah. Incredible. So
we need to work hard because when you have kids, they always want mm-hmm. something different every day, and like school, especially my son, my older son, he's in.
Mm-hmm. All right. So I hope that makes you feel better, Alessi. Now we're gonna break in. Go into the breakout rooms. Let's go.
There's
we're gonna
a lot
go.
Of power.
Yeah. No, I'm sorry. Keep going. Okay. So we're gonna go into breakout rooms, and I want to ask everybody in breakout room to try to find common ground. So even though we're very, like I mentioned before, even though we're very, very, very different people, a lot of these things can connect us. Like what Natalia mentioned, money. There's nobody here who doesn't feel stress from money. Family stress, work stress, all of these things, we can find a common ground. And so essentially what I'm challenging you to do in this breakout room is find some connections with the people in class, make a friend, that sort of thing. So the way, Garcon, you're on your feet right now working like you do every day. Yeah, Alessi,
I can do the assignment with another people.
Yeah, yeah.
I have it done.
You might have a lot in common with Alessi, even though you have, you know, you're seemingly different people with different backgrounds, you still will have this in common. So that's what I want to challenge everybody to do today, is try to find common ground with somebody in this class. So what brings you stress? Try to find something that connects everybody. And I'm going to put everyone in, how many, let's see, three breakout rooms. So
perfect.
Everybody understand what I mean by common ground?
Yeah, we understand.
I do.
Great. Okay, here we go. Three breakout rooms. Okay, and you can join your breakout room now. Hello, I don't see, are you able to join the breakout room? Now. All right, so I'll say the last thing I said. This is a brand new assignment. It's titled Tough Lessons for Kids. And attached is one article. The vocabulary will be pretty difficult, but we'll go over it together. And I'll attach a separate vocabulary list for you. And the assignment is going to be a presentation. So it's a speaking assignment, not a writing assignment. So very similar to the way several of you did a great job presenting what you made for us in class. I will ask everybody to present next class. So do I have a volunteer to read the instructions for this assignment?
I like to read, teacher.
Absolutely. Was that Fareed or was that Natalia?
Mary.
Marie, okay, yes.
Can I?
Okay, yes, absolutely.
The children's TV programs, Sesame Street. Sesame Street has begun in the late 1970s with a social mission. Today, the program is broadcast in 120 countries and aims to teach two life lessons to young people. We will read these two articles in class. For our next live class, please prepare a 2-3 minute presentations about of an episode of Sesame Street. You tell was important. If you are unable to give your presentation in class, please record a video and update it on YouTube or TikTok.
All right, very good, very good. So I'm gonna stop sharing right now and just give a demonstration of what I mean. So many people will not be able to make class because a lot of people are working. So all you gotta do is this. That's it. So you can speak and then record it and then just upload it on YouTube or TikTok. That's it. And the reason I said do not just send it on WhatsApp, guess why?
Because WhatsApp is used for send and the information, the all group, the quickly, at time.
I don't want it to take up, it takes up too much space on everybody's phone.
Okay.
When you send it on WhatsApp, WhatsApp will automatically download it onto your phone. So all of a sudden you have no memory, you have no space on your phone. You're like, what's going on? I can't do anything. Oh, 10 people sent me their videos on WhatsApp and now they're all stuck on my phone. So that's why I'm saying just upload. If you cannot make the live class, upload your video to YouTube or to TikTok. And we of course can go over that before next week. But let's see, before that, does anybody have any questions about that assignment, what I'm asking you to do?
Yeah, teacher, where you can send it, the homework? Where you can send it?
Did you say what or when?
Where?
Yes. You want to upload a video onto either, well, actually, the homework will be done live. It depends. If you can make the live class next week on Monday, then you just present it in class.
Okay.
But if you cannot make it to class, then just make a little tiny short video, very, very short.
Oh.
And then put it on YouTube or TikTok and then just put the link and just attach the link. That's it.
Okay, I got it now.
All right. So yeah, it depends on everybody's schedule. If you can make it to class, great. You don't have to attach anything. You just give it a speaking class. If you cannot make it to class, then you just attach the link to a YouTube or a TikTok link. Does that make sense to everybody? Okay. This is my test. If it makes sense to everybody, say absolutely nothing.
Teacher.
All right. Beautiful. Yes, Perla.
The topic we want to speak for recording is the Sesame Street.
Good question. We will go over, I'm going to go over right now.
Okay.
The instructions, no problem. So I'm going to go over those instructions one more time with everybody. So here we go. Let me just go back to sharing my screen. Here we go. Okay. So back to the screen share. So here is what Marie just read. So we will read these two articles in class. For our next live class, please prepare a 2 to 3 minute presentation about an episode of Sesame Street you felt was important. So for instance, you could say an episode I felt was important was, and then that's when you look in either of these articles for information, particularly this one. And Perla, I'm glad you asked that question because it leads me into the first article. So here it is. 7 times Sesame Street taught kids about real life. This is taking a while to come up. Hold on a second. Let me see if I can switch browsers. Oh, there it is. There it is. Okay. So there it is. This is a children's show, but oftentimes they deal with very serious content. Okay. So what this show does very well is that it teaches kids about real life. Usually a lot of programming for television is silly and doesn't really help out people with real life situations. But there are a lot of very real situations that this show helps people with around the world. So the first time this show really tackled a serious topic was, in the 1980s. Now let's take a look at this one. It says, number one, Mr. Hooper dies. And there's a video of the episode. The topic, the real life topic that the show made for children is this. Death. Now I'm gonna put on the video panel. Here's a quick question. Has anyone here ever had to speak to children about death?
Sorry?
Has anyone here ever had to talk to children about death? Explain death to children? It's a very, very difficult thing to do.
Yeah.
But it's a part of life. And in the year 1983, this show created a program specifically on death. And its game was aimed at very small children because an older member of the cast died, the actor died. And usually when an actor dies, they replace the character with a different actor and keep going. But they didn't do that. When the actor died, they killed the character. They didn't write and they didn't keep the character alive and have a new actor come in. They made an episode about the man who played the character and how he actually died. And they did that to explain to children that death was real. And this was a brand new thing to do.
Interesting.
So, yeah, and this is how, and let's take a look at how they did it. And this was in 1983. Let's get a volunteer reader. Who would like to read this next part?
Me too. Me, teacher.
Glaucia. All right. Yes. Go for it.
If you were a kid in 1980s, you likely remember Thanksgiving 1983, the day that Sesame Street confronted the death of Will Lee, who spent 14 seasons playing Mr. Hopper.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Big Bird draws a picture of Mr. Hopper and wants to show it to him. But the human cast members remind him that Mrs. Hopper died. Then try to help Big Bird understand what that means. Parents watch it with their kids and answer questions they had about death.
Yep. So kids in the 1980s suddenly were able to understand, okay, death is means you're not coming back. That's it. And it was a game changer for children's programming. It was suddenly children's programming was not just about being silly and dancing around and living in a fantasy. It was about dealing with real world problems and facing them head on. This had never been done before. Now, what's good about this particular article is that it has a YouTube clip about exactly which episode it was. So I'm gonna play this for everybody, and then I wanna get your opinions. Is it a good idea or a bad idea to make a children's program about death? Here we go.
And last but not least, ta-da!
Oh, look at that one. That's
so beautiful.
That's nice.
Everybody can hear, yeah?
Yes.
Okay.
Really
nice.
Can I see
that?
Yeah.
Oh, that's really good.
Really, really looks like it.
Yeah, you captured him.
Wow, that's beautiful, Big Bird.
Oh, thank
really
you.
Really nice.
Oh, thank you.
Mm. Wonderful. Mm.
Oh, well, I can't wait till he sees it. Say, where is he? I want to give it to him. I know. He's in the store.
A Big Bird?
Huh?
He's not in there.
Oh. Then where is he?
Big Bird, don't you remember we told you? Mr. Hooper died. He's dead.
Oh, yeah. I remember. Well, I'll give it to him when he comes back.
Big Bird, Mr. Hooper's not coming back.
Why not?
Big Bird, when people die, they don't come back.
Ever?
No, never.
Why not?
Well, Big Bird, they're dead. They can't come back.
Well, he's gonna come back. Why, who's gonna take care of the store? And who's gonna make my birdseed milkshakes and tell me stories?
Big Bird,
I'm gonna take care of the store. Mr. Hooper, he left it to me. And I'll make you your milkshakes and we'll all tell you stories and
sure,
we'll make sure you're okay.
Sure, we'll look after you.
Oh. Hmm. Well, he won't be the same.
You're right, Big Bird. It'll never be the same around here without him.
Mm.
But you know something?
We can all be very happy that we had a chance to be with him and to know him.
Yeah.
And to love him a lot when he was here.
Yeah.
And Big Bird, we still have our memories of him.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, our memories. Right. Why, memories, that's how I drew this picture.
Yeah,
from memory.
Good. Yeah.
Yeah. And we can remember him and remember him and remember him. Not just we want to. But I don't like it. It makes me sad.
We all feel sad, Big Bird.
He's never coming back?
Never?
No. Well, I don't understand. You know, everything was just fine. Why does it have to be this way? Give me one good reason.
Big Bird, it has to be this way because.
Just because?
Just because.
Oh. You know, I'm going to miss you, Mr. Looper.
That's Hooper, Big Bird. Hooper.
Right.
Okay, everybody. Now, I want your opinions. This had never been done before. And this was almost, this was 39 years ago on TV. And suddenly parents had this tool. Oh my goodness, I can explain this to children in a new way. But a lot of people didn't like it at all. They thought this was so inappropriate to show children. But for many people, they said, this is great. I have a real tool to explain something serious to a child. What does everybody think? I want your opinions.
For me, I think it's appropriate to speak with your kids about die, death, because you know when it's happening, maybe it surprise you, maybe no. I think so. I put this video to my daughter today.
Very good, very good. Now, go for it.
I try to speak about this with my kid. Dora is really hard. She's. I try to explain in the life. We can be here in the life today and tomorrow. We can something like that. I try to.
I had this conversation with my son 2 months ago when my mother died. I didn't use this particular tool, but I had to. I essentially had to state the matter of fact. Very, very difficult.
Difficult because they don't understand we something. Yep.
Now, there's more. This is 1993. They did an episode about racism. And then in 2001, they did an episode about 9/11, terrorist attack 20 years ago. So they found a way to explain a terrorist attack with thousands of people dying to children. In another episode, let's see, what was this about? They talked about, okay, in this episode in 2002, they did an episode about AIDS. And this was particularly aimed at an audience in South Africa when AIDS was extremely widespread. So explaining very serious topics, but using puppets and using actors to take all these very serious things to explain to children. Breastfeeding in public. This was actually 1977. This is a character created in 2015 who's autistic. Does everyone know what autistic means?
Yes.
So yeah, they have a character named Julia who is autistic, and the actors who talk to the puppet explain, why is this character screaming? Why is this character yelling? Why is this character doing this? And they said, Julia is autistic. And then they give people ways to interact with people who are dealing with autism. So that's one article, and it shows clips of videos about how the show takes real life, very serious topics, and then makes it applicable for children. So that's what it's about. Now, the article that's a little harder and has much more complicated vocabulary, but we'll go over it together next week, is the history of it. And this is a Smithsonian article. So this is more getting you ready for college level reading. So you'll see a lot more vocabulary. When you open this, you're gonna say, oh, so much English. George, why are you doing this to me? But don't worry, we'll go over that together. Now, what I'd like you to do is prepare for next week, a short presentation, just talk about an episode. You can use one from the article, or you could find one on your own. You can use YouTube, or you could use the PBS Kids app. Either one is fine. And talk about one that you thought was particularly important. So I'll underline this right here. For our next class, prepare a 2 to 3 minute presentation about an episode you felt was important. So something you thought was important. And I think I'll attach another resource or two here to help you out. They've done episodes on divorce. They've done episodes on prison, because so many American families have a member of the family in prison. They had the characters explaining to a child, your father is in prison, and this is what happened. So very, very serious topics, but they explain it to children. And that's it. So for tomorrow, get to reading and watching and preparing a presentation for Monday. Are you excited?
Yes.
All right. Well, then I will see you on Monday.
Hello.
And tomorrow, I look forward to seeing, to hearing everything that you're reading and watching. All right. See you later, everybody.
Bye.
That's the class for today.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye, everyone.
Have a great day, y'all.
You too. Bye-bye.
See you Monday.
See you.